Alright, here we're going to show you how to perform the internal inspection portion for air brakes. In subchapter F, for medium, heavy truck and buses equipped with air brakes, this is a check that needs to be performed. So one of the first items, it says, is any brake warning system is not working. We will be checking that during this process, but just to show you real quick, when we turn on the light, you'll hear a buzzer, that's our low air buzzer, and you also saw a lamp there. It went out because our air pressure is not low right now, but that is the low air pressure warning light. On this vehicle, it looks like a circle with three arrows pointing inwards, indicating pressure. So one of the first checks the inspection procedure lists for air brakes says, with the engine stopped and brakes not applied, the gauge indicates a loss of 3 pounds per minute. Now you'll notice on this truck, we have two air pressure gauges. The top one here has letter P, that's our primary, and below it we have a secondary air pressure gauge. They should be very close to the same, but we have two systems, and we have two gauges. On some vehicles, you will see a single gauge used, but they will use two needles, two different color needles. On this one, the orange needle is the secondary, and the white needle is the primary, if you have this type of gauge with two needles. To do this test, it said with the engine stopped, not running, so that's taken care of, and brakes not applied. That means not pressing on the service brakes, but it also means the parking brakes must be released. So make sure that the wheels are chocked, which we did prior to starting this video, and we're going to release our parking brakes. Give the parking brakes a moment to stabilize pressure, and then you're going to watch that gauge for that specified 1 minute. Now, it's a good idea to maybe snap a picture of it with a phone so you have something to compare with. We're not going to do that for this case, but I will start our timer now, taking note of where both needles are. This gauge is in 25 PSI increments, so it's a little hard to recognize small air losses, but we're allowed to lose up to 3 PSI per minute. So we're going to let this go for a full minute and see if our gauge moved. I would say on this gauge, 3 PSI would be basically the width of a needle. All right. So a minute has now went by. I would say our top gauge has not moved at all. Our gauge for our lower gauge for the secondary has moved the slightest bit, maybe 1 or 2 PSI, but would seem to be within that limits. So we'll move on to our next test. And that is with the engine running, the gauge indicates a loss of more than 4 pounds per minute after full brake application for 2 minutes. Now, as you know, when that engine's running, it is going to build air. So what it's talking about is we will need to start the truck and run it to governor cutout. Governor cutout, we will recognize by a few things. We'll see the needle basically peak, reach its highest point and stop. We will also often hear the air dryer exhaust, a clue that we reached governor cutout. So what we're going to do, I'm going to explain it now before the truck is running. We're going to start this truck up, reach governor cutout. My parking brake is still released. I'm then going to apply the service brakes. Now it mentions 2 minutes. What that is saying is allow 2 minutes or up to 2 minutes for these pressures to stabilize. If I have a trailer hooked up on here, it's going to take a little longer. We don't have to wait a full 2 minutes. We're just going to wait until we see these gauges stabilize, start our timer at that point, and we want to make sure we're not losing more than 4 PSI per minute. So let's proceed with that test. All right, so we just reached governor cutout. We're going to apply our brakes, full brake application, and we'll start our timer here in a moment. We want to make sure that stabilizes and start our timer. All right, so my foot is still on the brakes. I didn't move it. I've kept it pressed to the floor. Our 1 minute's up. We definitely had a significant air loss there. It looked like our secondary gauge started at about 115 PSI, and at the end of 1 minute, we were about at 105. The primary looks like it was at 110 and maybe ended at 105. So with the secondary gauge alone, we are definitely exceeded that 4 PSI per minute limit, and this would fail. It would be important then to figure out the source of this air leak. I do already hear an air leak coming from the dash, but you can get a helper or apply a a brake pedal depressor and look around the truck and find out where the other air leaks are to be able to determine the proper fix. We will proceed with our inspection procedure. At this point, we can now apply our service brake again by pulling out the dash valve. And the next step, we're actually going to skip ahead to D. We're going to skip over C and come back to that. D says a warning device, audible or visible, does not operate at all pressures at and below 60 psi. So you want to make sure that both air brake warning devices, the buzzer and the warning light, come on by the time you reach 60 psi or lower. The best way to drain that air pressure is going to be to pump the brake pedal and to see what pressure those warning devices come on. Obviously, the key has to be on. Now, on some trucks, that buzzer will continue to go constantly when there's no oil pressure. So in that case, it may be necessary to have the truck running when you do this test. But in this case, that buzzer is not running right now, so we can check and see if it pops on by the time we reach 60. So we're going to pump the brake pedal, watching the gauges as we go. A lot of modern trucks will turn on by the time it reaches 75 or 70 PSI. That's fine. It just has to be on by the time we hit 60. And there you can see it just turned on. We have our light. We hear our buzzer. This gauge here looks like it's at about at 60 or maybe 65. The other gauge is up closer to 70. But it came on, so our buzzer and our indicator are working. That portion of the test would pass. Now, going back to item C, that regulation states that while the engine is, or with the engine running at fast idle, the time to raise pressure to cutout exceeds 5 minutes. Now, it's a little vague. This doesn't tell us what pressure we're starting at. Doesn't say if we're starting with the air tanks fully drained. Doesn't say if we're starting at 60 PSI or if we're starting actually at governor cut-in. So what I typically do, we'll start at 60 PSI, basically the same place I want to be to check the buzzer. We'll start it up. Now notice it says at fast idle. So we're not talking about idle. We're talking about, it could even be governor RPM or probably 3/4 throttle. You want to give the truck decent amount of throttle. Make sure it builds up to governor cutout within 5 minutes. If it's close to that or excessive, there is a problem. You could have a poorly functioning compressor. You could have a blocked air filter or air intake to the compressor. But you'd want to find out what's going on there. So let's get ready to start our timer, and we'll then start the truck to perform this test. All right, so there we reached governor cutout at basically 4 minutes, 5 seconds, 7 seconds till I hit the timer. This is within specs, but it did take a relatively long time to build up air. So this would pass, but there could certainly be these air leaks causing part of the problem with buildup. You want to make sure it doesn't exceed 5 minutes, otherwise that is a concern. So that completes the internal inspection portion for air brakes. If you recall, this truck did fail for excessive air leaks when the service brake was applied, and so that would be a fail, but it did pass the warning devices, that portion passed, and the air buildup just was marginal, but it did make it. So hopefully this is going to help in performing the PA safety inspection.